The brain gut axis has been the subject of research for several decades, but it's really only within the last 15 years that microbes within the intestine have been regarded as important in signaling from gut to brain, and of course, signaling from brain back to gut. Within the adult human intestine, we have about a kilo to a kilo and a half of bacteria. So that's the same weight as the human brain. When we look at the biochemistry of that virtual organ, and by a virtual organ I mean the entire collection of microbes within the gut, it's biochemically very complex. And our brain and other organs in our body are dependent upon the microbes in our gut to produce molecules that the organs actually require. In turn, we feed those microbes. So the microbes produce a variety of molecules, and without those molecules, our brains would not be able to function normally. When we look at the ways in which the microbes communicate with the brain, the vagus nerve is an important route of communication. We've shown that certain microbes cannot communicate with the brain if the vagus nerve has been cut. Another important route of communication is the production of short-chain fatty acids. Short-chain fatty acids like butyrate, propionate, acetate are the metabolic product of the microbes. They can get into the bloodstream and travel to the brain. Now, there is some controversy as to how they actually function within the brain. There is evidence that they can act as epigenetic modulators, that they can modulate the way in which genes in the neurons actually operate. But they also act through classic receptors called G protein coupled receptors. It's generally assumed that these short chain fatty acids do have an important role to play. Another very important role of the microbes is the production of tryptophan. Now, we taught previously that all the tryptophan came from the diet. We now know that microbes in the gut, particularly bifidobacteria, actually synthesize tryptophan. And tryptophan, of course, is the necessary precursor for serotonin. Without tryptophan, we do not have adequate precursor to produce serotonin and to maintain serotonergic transmission. And of course, serotonin as a neurotransmitter in the human brain plays a fundamental role in regulating mood, sleep, and appetite.